He walks outside. He's like, oh,
no shit.
Like,
hey,
you know, there's the three of them sitting around the studio
re-recording
three different party loops, and they put it all together. I did one of those on a rap album, so yeah. I know how those are done.
You know how it works. What was the name of the rap album?
The album?
It was the group.
It was Pimps in Paradise.
Pimps in Paradise, nice.
But the skit with the talking was The Barbecue.
That right there was Jason Luke, Toby Blake. Jason Luke, Toby Blake.
Featuring Toby Keith.
Featuring Jason Mraz.
Fuck you, for going.
No, that doesn't work. Doesn't have the same name. Anyway, what do you guys think of this song?
It's hard to hear.
That's what I would.
You recorded that off the radio?
Yeah.
he's kicking it like he's 12 again.
That's what I would assume that your guys' outlook on Nickelback would be. Like that one.
That sounds like a Nickelback song, yeah.
Okay.
To me.
Okay.
Sure.
Well, I just figured after we spent 2 weeks apart, let's get some Nickelback
rimming. Did you say Nickelback rimming?
Yeah, Nickelback rimming in there. And I thought
feel
it was actually awesome that you guys didn't know that was like that. You thought that was their new tune.
It's an old tune.
Old.
It's new to me.
It's mold. If it's not,
maybe I'm one of those old. You know, I'm just getting into Nickelback. You know, like, you know, like when you're a kid and you just find out Led Zeppelin exists or something, and you go through the whole back catalog and you're like, oh my god,
listen to these deep tracks.
I'll do that with Nickelback when I'm like 45
and giving up.
Alright, well, either way, I'm sorry that you gentlemen don't share our
love
for Nickelback.
Fucking
Nickelback
deep,
live forever.
Love.
Welcome to the
for
William
Nickelback.
Barron Show. We are sorry that we took last week off, but Joe, you had a wedding to preside.
Yeah, that's right. I presided over a wedding.
How did that go?
I was the officiant.
Aficionado?
No, officiant. Aficionado would be, had I done it multiple times, I suppose. It went great. I think the bride and groom are very happy.
Did you crack any jokes?
I took it a little seriously, you know. I wanted
did you?
To, I just, well, you know, I was fun. I was nice.
Do you think they were nervous that you were going to crack jokes? Because if you were
officiating.
There we go. Our wedding, I would expect.
You would expect some light ribbing,
uh-huh.
Maybe some jokes.
Yes.
Well, you know, I wanted to leave that to the best man for his, you know, speech.
So when we get remarried, can you do our wedding?
Absolutely.
Can you
sure.
make it funny as fuck, though?
Well, that I can do.
And embarrassing.
Yeah.
And great.
I could roast you guys and also renew your vows.
Yes. A roast and renew.
How long does your license
it.
Last for? Is it like a lifetime
yeah,
kind of thing?
I'm in the
forever.
Church. Yeah.
Forever.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nice. Well, I want to do it in the next 2 years, though.
We just hit 7. You can't do a 9-year.
No,
yeah. We're about to hit 8, yo.
7-year itch, man. We made it.
That's what I'm thinking.
7-year itch.
We're about to hit 8, motherfucker. I want to do it at 10.
Right. So you,
not at like 20 or 30. Because then I'll just
you
be
say
old
you
and ugly.
Do it in 2 years, that means like a 9-year.
No.
Anniversary.
We're almost at 8.
Okay.
Yo.
So
you call our son 2.5. He's nowhere near 2.5. Yet we're not almost 8.
How
years
far
old.
Away is he from 2.5?
8 months.
8 months from 2.5?
Yes.
So from he's 2 and 16 a half. Months?
No, he's eight months away
from being three.
Yes.
Which means that he's 2 months away from being 2 and a half.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So you want to
But you've been calling this motherfucker 2 and a half.
You keep wanting to call him two when he's closer to 2 and a half.
He is my little motherfucker.
He is closer to 2 and a half than he is to 2. In fact, he's closer to 3 than he is to 2.
Listen, this potty trained motherfucker right here.
By 1 month.
Bullshit.
Look at my dookie.
Yeah, he's always calling you in to look at his crap. And his
he is. He's super proud of it every time
toilet
happens.
Seat.
He's like, Daddy, I pooped.
Look what happened. Look what came out of me.
Come look, Daddy.
It's disgusting.
Bill's always like, yay, good job, bud. I ain't cleaning it.
If it's dry,
I'll leave it there all day for mom.
Turn it over into the toilet and it goes, plunk, plunk. I'm cool with that. I can wipe out the toilet with the fucking, with the baby wipe.
You're making me sick.
I can wipe out. When it's
nasty.
When my daughter comes out and says that it looks like ice cream, and I go in there and it looks like ice cream, and I hold it over the toilet and it doesn't come off.
I can just picture that.
I even approached it as if I'm gonna scoop you up this baby wipe.
You gotta get like one of the sand shovels that they have from their little bucket pal and just kind of
little scoop you have for the kitty litter.
Just scoop, scoop. Yep. No, but then you gotta wipe it down. I couldn't do it. The stench was so strong. It was like
I got to clean 3 different potty chairs the other day. It was great. I get out of the shower and I get to clean 3 different toilets of shit. Because Bill couldn't do it.
Why do you have so many toilets?
What do you mean 3?
Well, he pooped on the actual potty when I was in the shower. And then you woke up and let him.
On the toilet seat that you sit on?
Uh-huh.
He
yeah.
Smeared it around?
Uh-huh.
Like he left you a present?
Yes.
I don't even know how I got up there, to be honest with you.
That sounds like the worst roommate I could ever have.
He's a climber. He's a climber. He likes to climb on shit. And then shit on it.
And show it. Show it to you.
Yes.
Babies are the worst roommate ever. This kid comes and shits on my toilet seat.
Yep.
Smears it around. And then tells me to clean it up.
And smiles
and
at
clean
me.
His ass at the same time. Yeah. You get to do both. I would rather wipe a diaper.
Mm.
Who potty trained his ass?
There was one.
Who wanted his ass potty trained? You.
Humans.
You.
Humans.
You wanted him potty trained.
The society contract?
Any natural
contract? No, William. You wanted him potty trained, yet you will not clean out his potty chair.
Gentlemen, I say this in the most...
Well, maybe you should go over math with the boy and you handle the potty.
He's not going to leave him in a shitty diaper all day for me to clean, but he will leave shit in a potty chair all day for me to clean it.
I won't leave it all day. Stop it with your nonsense.
I think you would.
Stop it.
Well, we already learned that.
You think I really
that
think you
her
would.
Her version of all day or all year is completely different
15
from
15 minutes. That's what all day means to her, 15 minutes.
I really think...
All day to me means that fucking... White fuzz starts growing on it by the end of the fucking day.
I swear to God, I think if it was a day that you had him all day long and he pooped in that potty chair, ice cream style.
Let me ask you.
You
let
would
me
fucking
you,
leave that shit for me to clean
me
it at 5:30 when
many,
I got
how
home.
How many times have I left ice cream shit?
How often have I left soft serve?
Soft serve.
Chalk of soft serve.
With the little Tweedledee at the top.
The curly Q.
Yep.
It does.
How many times
when
have
that
I
boy
done
shits,
that?
He shits.
As far as my recollection.
It's happening.
And I'm drunk a lot, so correct me if I'm wrong, but it was like Tuesday was the only time that I left a curly Q soft serve.
Well, he had
shit.
He did have diarrhea that one time.
Well, what is your favorite kind of poop to clean up then, Bill?
Hard.
Constipated shit.
Rolls off of the potty chair.
So
into
you're
the
constantly
toilet.
Shoving cheese and salted snacks down his throat.
A rabbit pellet poop.
No. You don't need to drink that water. Yep. Put that water down. You haven't eaten enough crackers.
Milk. No, you don't get no milk.
I'm shoving milk down his throat.
No, I know. No, coincidentally, the boy loves cheese.
There you go.
So, anyway. Yeah.
He makes that kind of smiley face.
Rabbit pellets Bill has no problem with.
But he's not really smiling.
The nasty loose shit.
Yep.
No.
Jesus taking effect.
William cannot handle the Nancy
when it,
Lee
when
shit.
It comes out too easy.
And it is
easy,
gross.
It
is gross. He's like, I'm gagging. I'm like, you think I don't gag?
No.
You think I'm not gagging, wiping this fucking diarrhea shit out of this body chair with my hand?
Well, if you haven't turned the podcast off yet, well, thank you for sticking with us.
So gross. It is gross. I would rather wipe a diaper.
Well, you know, and the other day, he actually went and shit on the potty.
God, love that little
man. On the little
boy potty.
He
has been the best potty
trained. Took his own pants off, too, yeah. which is a good step in the right direction.
Ladies.
He
took his own pants off.
Took his own pants
off. None of that. No.
He can't have them around the ankles yet.
I don't care if we're doing this podcast in 15 years. There will be no talking of my son's pants off.
Dance off?
Pants off, dance off.
Ever. It's not going to happen.
It's pants off, dance off time. Unless he's shitting.
No, when he's shitting, like, yeah, I'll take it to his ankles, and he'll be, I can't deal with that. So he's got to kick his pants off.
Spread it out.
Have you taken him to a bathroom publicly yet?
Yeah.
You need to teach this boy how to pee standing up.
Anytime I try and teach him how to point it down, like, by touching it, he's like, Dad, no.
Yeah, he doesn't like you to touch it.
Guaranteed he's going to know bathroom etiquette.
Well, then you're going to
public bathroom
piss all over my fucking chest.
We all know
son.
Who his father is.
When are you going to teach him to stand up and pee? When does that happen? Like what?
After he wipes his own ass.
Not till then?
I'm waiting for the day. When that day comes.
It takes that long?
I swear to God, I'm going to keep that.
I mean, does anybody know? Does anybody know
I'm
when you
keep
teach a little boy
piece
to
of
stand
toilet
up
paper.
Peeing up? Because I'm ready for him to stand peeing.
Well, he has to be tall
He's
enough.
Not tall enough to hit the toilet.
I know. He's so tiny.
Oh, thank you.
Oh! Bye. You don't want to talk about little boy potty training. I can't believe we just talked 15 minutes about our son's potty training habits. Sorry, listeners. That's what's going on in the Barron house these days.
This segment
brought to you by
was brought to you by StickerMule.com. They make great products that'll last a lifetime. Right?
Extremely.
Extremely durable. Pee daddy.
It's just a slow-mo. Of Bill's son sitting on the toilet, peeing all over his chest.
Triumphantly pulling down his own pants.
And Bill's trying to push it down.
It's like a leaky faucet.
Has that happened?
It's happened to me.
I was going
to
ask you, because it's happened to me.
It's happened
so
to me.
I would imagine it's happened to you.
Standing in front of the potty.
Yeah.
Triumphantly.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Welcome back to the William Barron Show. This segment is brought to you by BlackBalloonStudio.com. We actually are coming up on our one-year anniversary.
Woohoo!
We took a look at our numbers. We're gonna go into another year, yeah. Which is exciting.
We be as re-signing.
Sweet.
Re-signing our contract.
Year.
We were a free agent, or we are a free agent. Actually,
yeah,
we need
we're
to use that to
a free
our
agent.
To our.
I hope your landlord doesn't listen to this.
No. No. She does. She's like 800 years old. She's Diane, I love you, but anyway, I threw a
she can work a curb.
I ain't saying shit.
Wow.
She can walk a curb just fine.
Let me just say that if she fell down like I fell down today, she'd be in the hospital. Other than that, today I threw out a question on Facebook to send us some questions to talk
sure.
about.
What do we get?
I was a little bit short. Kevin from Chicago wants to know, being a month into our NHL season.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Out of all the teams that are in the National Hockey League,
mm-hmm.
which team, Joe, has surprised you the most? Your individual team.
My individual idea yes. of a surprising NHL team.
Like the team that exceeded your expectations so far in the season.
I'm still surprised that the Mighty Ducks got a team.
Okay.
That they went from a movie to a professional hockey team.
True.
The Mighty Ducks are a hockey team? What the fuck? Seriously?
Yeah.
That's not a joke?
No.
Is the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim? Is that what it is?
I don't
are
know.
They, are they? They gotta be LA.
I thought they were Florida. No, Disney World.
No,
I am gonna look it up.
Mighty
Ducks.
What I'm gonna
do.
Or Ontario.
I have to figure it out.
Ontario.
I have to know. This is brand new.
The Ontario Mighty Ducks.
They got rid of the Flying V. That's what surprised me the most this year, is that they no longer do the Flying V.
Well,
that's their trademark.
I mean, well, that's what they did.
I mean, new coach, new rules. I see, but come on. I mean, you gotta throw away your history.
That being said,
Flying V.
That's like Wrigley Field getting rid of Ivy. I mean, come on.
Yeah, one day that's not gonna grow back.
Come on, Ducks.
Anaheim.
There it is. Anaheim. Yeah, Disneyland.
Ooh, right? Donald Ducks. The mighty Donald Ducks.
It is Anaheim.
I was told that I do a Daffy Duck over the weekend.
You do a Daffy Duck?
The old Daffy Duck.
Let's hear the Daffy Duck.
Where the Daffy, he's like, ha, ha, ha,
that's Goofy.
I don't remember that. No,
that's not Goofy.
No,
that
Goofy.
That used to be my Mickey Mouse.
Okay.
And I was told that it sounds too much like Daffy Duck.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, I know. I got to work on it. Yeah, that's. I don't have kids, so it's.
It's hard to do. Wreck-It Ralph.
Yeah.
Well, I've never seen it.
I'm gonna see
Riley.
It.
Yeah,
John C. Reilly.
Oh, yeah.
You just talk like you're talking.
Hey, man. I can't even hear it.
You feel good about that? Just actors that are known. Actually do voiceover work and like be creative with it.
I love it. John C. Reilly, though, to me, like in Wreck-It Ralph, goddamn, we come back to this fucking movie a lot.
Because you cry a lot every time you see it.
You bring it up.
It's
emotional.
I do love the fucking movie. Mm. But no, I don't have a problem with
I love that fucking kids movie.
It's a good movie. It is.
It's a great movie, but no, I mean, Sarah Silverman did a part on that, and Avril Lavigne did a part on that. I mean, speaking of Avril Lavigne, but I don't have a problem with with actors. I think they're flooding the market. I think they're taking a lot of good voice acting jobs away from voice actors that know how to voice act. Like, you've been playing Batman.
Mm-hmm. The video game.
The video game, yeah.
No, Batman. I've actually been dressing up like Batman.
Oh!
You've been playing Batman.
I've been playing Batman in the streets of Peoria, Illinois.
Wow. He now does his laundry in the Batman costume.
I do.
Nice. At least you don't get the half chub.
Just in case.
You got the titanium chub.
He puts the sock in there.
Take the laundry out for an hour.
But, I mean, like, do you...
No, Craig, the sock goes in on the other side of the underwear, buddy.
Damn.
But, like, just...
Don't make fun of my bat.
My bat poop.
My bat hemorrhoid.
Oh, gross.
You're going to be Julie Bell for the bat preparation.
Oh, nasty.
But like I'm sure that like kid movies where voice acting is dominant and video games where voice acting is dominant, or I mean, you can always tell when a movie, an actual Hollywood film, like when the camera's to the back of their head, you can hear them be like, "Well, I want you to come back," and it doesn't sound like the same sound form, the same sound wave. No, all right.
I don't know. All right, anyway,
you lost us.
It's all voiceover
shit. I have
shit,
no idea what you're talking about,
but. Like, I played Call of Duty. It came out. And I give it a fucking flat D-.
Ooh.
I mean...
The new one?
The new one. The new one that came out, that you got commercials all day long about it. But my problem with that was, A, they spent too much money on sound effects. Not enough money on voice acting. Mm. And not enough money on a script. So... Mm. When you play a game where the script is not only bad, but the voice acting,
I don't think
matches.
It has to do with. Doesn't have to do with money that much, does it?
I would think
they just had the wrong.
No,
because
I mean, you get Cameron Diaz to do another voiceover job for $10 million. You might be able to get a voice actor for $200,000.
Yeah,
right. And get better quality.
Right.
So
but if
you can throw more money at it, doesn't mean you're going to get a better performance out of somebody.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
That's what he's saying.
Yeah, like they didn't. I'm not saying that they didn't spend enough money. Maybe they didn't spend enough time trying to find the right voice actors.
They didn't spend the right resources on the right things to get it done.
They didn't have the script before they started making the game.
Well, and when the people that were reading the script, they had absolutely no idea what the fuck. Like, seriously, there was a...
Was it delivered like a book of porno?
It really was. I mean, it was... There was this very dramatic part.
I got to get to class.
I think I'm going to be tardy. All
right. There was a very dominant part in this storyline of Call of Duty. And I play the campaign. I don't understand why nobody ever plays the campaign, but... I played the campaign, and they're talking about these ghosts.
They're there's like ghosts in it now.
The elite Marines.
Oh, they're coming.
You can't kill them. They're so...
They're too good.
So dirty and so sneaky and so... They're ghosts.
Yeah.
You don't even see them.
Oh, they're not really ghosts.
No, they're not. Oh, I see. They're not like Sixth Sense ghosts.
I thought this was like the ghosts of the best soldiers of all time.
No, that would have been better.
Now you're trying to fight them. That would have
been better. Now you're trying to fight actually a ghost.
One of these bastards tripped Bill this morning. Swooped right in there.
Not going to lie.
Sniper.
Not going to lie.
Sniper.
God damn it. Motherfucker tripped me. Not going to lie. That would be a better storyline.
No,
but anyway.
No.
No. But the storyline, like, you go through an hour and a half of this fucking stupid-ass storyline. You and your brother, like, fighting through this catastrophe.
What do you mean by brother?
Like, my legitimate brother.
Okay.
Fighting side by side, trying to get to our dad because he's old and crippled. And then you come to find out that he is the ghost.
Whoa, spoiler alert.
I don't give a fuck.
Oh, no.
I am sitting...
Game's been out for a week, motherfucker.
If you haven't been playing this game yet...
You haven't gotten to the ghost yet.
If you haven't played this game yet, you're going to be fantastically disappointed.
Way more disappointed than what I just told you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the first point. Yeah, just keep playing.
You're playing multiplayer anyway.
Yeah.
Chances are.
Yeah. Yeah, you're not even paying attention to the most expensive part of the game.
You get sniped by an 11-year-old boy.
Creeping.
Yeah.
What do they call that?
Camping.
Oh, camping.
Yeah.
Camping.
Yeah, yeah. When you lay down in a patch of grass and you just look at one direction,
you just
wait
for people
fucking time, and you just wait for one guy to come.
That sounds like cheating.
Fucking walking around the corner and being like, what the fuck am I doing?
Let's see. I think I got the hang of this game. Okay, left is right. Okay. Oh, whoops. Okay, amp. Oh, what the hell?
Yeah. I'm doing the book, man.
All right. Let's try this again. Like, let me just get up there.
I'm just going to move over to the left.
Come up on this hill. Yeah. Son of a... Okay. Here we go.
I know where he's at now.
I'm kind of... I know where he's at. Kind of against this wall now. I'm creeping. Okay. I'll just lean over and...
oh, son of a...
Oh, wow, nice vocal there, William.
and the voice acting to when they die is so awesome. It's like...
And then do you get a message from the guy that shot you?
Or bitch.
Do you talk?
Sorry, sir.
Bitch.
Suck it.
No, yeah. You
Sorry, old man. I just killed your ass.
Yeah. I know. I'm the ghost.
Go back to Halo.
We'll be right back after this Aaron Band show.
How you doing? It's your son now. And I picked up the mic and put the drugs down. Now I'm trying to do some things that'll make you proud. Instead of every time I call, it's to build me up. And then I listen to things you used to tell me.
Welcome back to the William Barron Show. This segment is brought to you by Baldoni Plumbing. If you are in Central Illinois, call 309-238-3416. Good guy, good work. Joe, let's get back to the wedding that you aficionado'd.
Yes. I am now the aficionado of giving weddings.
Yeah, buddy.
I can officiate any wedding in the states of America.
Any state.
Contiguous. I'd have to look into Hawaii and Alaska. So.
Mm. Okay. So any.
Puerto Rico is a gray area.
Canada, super gray.
Yeah.
Super gray in Canada. A.
But yeah, I went and got registered. Got ordained in the Church of the Universal Life Church.
How did it go? How did it go? I mean,
well, the ceremony was quick. Just one click and done on the internet there.
Drop down menu. Married, conjoined.
Choose your state.
No, I don't mean the process of registering. I mean the actual officiating.
We're going to have to fuse your heads
the
together.
The wedding.
Your
heads put together. Your actual J-O-B
or you guys can go with
for
the
day.
Hug.
How did it go? Like, were you nervous? Right, were you?
It was, no, I wasn't nervous.
No?
I was,
were you holding a book?
Did you have a
microphone?
Did you have a microphone?
I had a leather binder.
Too many questions going on.
I had a leather binder, so it looked professional.
Like a Bible?
No, like a
no.
Like a portfolio.
You didn't go Trapper Keeper.
Trapper Keeper.
Justin Bieber Trapper Keeper.
Yeah, let me just open this up.
Yeah. Exactly.
And let me just
kunk. Right.
Three hole punch that. Good. All right.
Come on. Next.
Well, I'm gonna hide my pencil in this little compartment here. No one will see that. So there was a microphone, and it was wireless, and there was no on off switch that I could see.
Mm-hmm.
And I just assumed it's hot, it's live, let's go.
Right. Somebody sound checked this. It wasn't my job.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got there, and there's already guests in there, so I didn't want to go out and be like,
mic check, one, two, aficionado here.
So I
don't
just,
mind me.
I start talking, and I'm like, this thing's not on. There's no way. So now I just project my voice as much
so
as I can.
You just shout.
And then my wife actually had to do a reading. And so she comes up and...
Same microphone. Okay.
And then when...
She fixes it, doesn't she?
Now I'm convinced this thing isn't on. Because she's standing there like, a reading from the... I'm like, there's no way. No way this thing's on. So finally, it eventually just got moved away. And we did it all. And it went well, you know? Nothing funny, nothing...
So you didn't come out and be like, a reading from the... You're trying to project your voice into a microphone you thought was dead.
We're here to join the two souls of these youths. No.
You were very serious about it, huh?
I was
Were you sober?
I was sober.
Nice.
Stone cold sober.
That's
a good way to go.
I want you to be drunk and hilarious.
All right, so we're going to do some PCP before we...
What?
PCP.
Mm-hmm.
Angel
dust.
What?
A little angel dust before we do this.
No, I don't know about
we're
going to
smoke a blunt.
Well, now
we're
going to
do
okay
four Jaeger bombs and chug four beers.
I'm
half
okay
of
with
them.
All of
then.
That. All of that's fine. PCP, no.
The entire bride's family, she is Asian. So her family, a lot of them are like first generation immigrants from China.
So they didn't know what you were saying.
Half of them might not have even understood what I was saying. They just sat there politely. And one of the things I kicked myself about was I'm
the old
people are coming
tooth floss
up, people
joke.
Are coming up to me.
Oh my God.
No, the
views of William Barron do not necessarily reflect those of the rest of the panel.
We love all human races.
We do. Go ahead.
Well, I tried to prepare for this thing as well as I could. And the one thing that didn't even cross my mind, right before the ceremony, my wife's uncle comes up to me. He goes, so you nervous? I'm like, no, I'm not nervous. I'm good. And he goes, oh. So what Chinese phrase did you learn?
Oh, my God.
And I'm like, what's that?
None.
And he says... Yeah, like, you know, you're going to say like a Chinese phrase, you know, just for the people in the audience to get a kick out of. And I was like, didn't even cross my mind. That was a real, and then I'm now I'm frantically Googling, like, how do I say congratulations, God. Blah, 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 husband, what, in Chinese. And it all comes up written in Chinese.
Oh, God.
And so then I'm like, okay, I'm pressing play, and it's and I'm like, she's well sound. So I'm like, there's no, I can't learn this in 2 minutes.
Oh, God.
So then someone was like, well, just hold the iPhone up there. You got the microphone. Microphone's not even on. It's like, you know.
Did you do it?
No.
Oh, okay.
What if it,
he's trusting the site to be right.
Yeah, I don't know what it says. It could have.
Now fuck your wife.
Yeah. Half the audience just gets up and leaves.
Suck it, people. Yeah, it said something about dental floss, and they all got up and left.
Oh, my God.
Go back to your own country, motherfuckers.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
So, no, I tried to just do it the best I could and be respectful. I got a lot of compliments,
but
no one thought that it was my first time.
Okay.
Wow. So that was good.
Which is kind of like his first time.
So, it was, you know, and that's all I wanted. I didn't want to distract. It wasn't about me. I wanted it to be about them.
Yeah.
And right. I don't want to get up there and be all like, hey, where do you hire that guy?
He's the Joey D Show.
Check out his podcast. All right. I'm like at the bumper sticker on my portfolio as I'm standing up there talking.
The William Barron Show.
William Barron Show.
Okay, sticker mule, that shit will stick to anything.
Uh-huh. It will.
Stickmule.com.
It's true. It's true. It's
yeah.
True. Them bitches did not come off.
Hopefully they're not listening to this right now. Well, even if they were, they couldn't understand what we're saying, so.
Sticker mule or the
people from the wedding?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, unless you were going to say.
No, the elders couldn't understand. The kids can all understand.
Uh-huh. Oh.
The kids are all grew up here.
You mean the ones that would be listening?
Right. The audience members that we might actually have.
Hello.
Hi.
Sorry about that dental floss thing.
Hey, you can call me a cracker. I'm okay.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. Do you guys have any, racial slurs? Like, there's been a big.
Oh, this sounds like a great topic.
No. You guys have racial slurs, you know?
What's your
favorite? On the table in a public forum?
Hold on, hold on. Come on, hold on. I'm sure that we've all heard about this Ritchie Incognito lineman from the Miami Dolphins who was told by the coach to give him a hard time, toughen him up.
Yeah.
And Ritchie Incognito, he's an offensive lineman, I think.
Yeah.
I don't even fucking know. This guy is such a nobody that I don't even
know. Well, no, he actually was Pro Bowl last year.
Well, that's fine. As an offensive lineman, nobody knows your fucking name as an offensive lineman.
Was voted the dirtiest player in the NFL in 2009.
Sure. Yeah. Hillenmeyer, that used to be a middle linebacker for the Bears, said that he always hated going up against him because he was just so dirty.
Yeah,
like he would.
What does it mean to be dirty as a football player, though? I mean,
hit you in the head, fucking punch you in the balls.
Maybe you go down and he'll grab an ankle and give it a little twist.
Yeah, stick his fingers in between your face mask, right on your eyeballs. Like he doesn't give a fuck. But
ew,
anything to get an edge.
But he kept calling this black guy an N-word. And holy shit.
And N-word or the N-word?
The N-word.
Naughty.
And the other N-word.
Notorious.
And for the past week and a half, we've been listening to every ESPN analysis guy be like, you know, all the black guys are like, it's disrespectful, it's fucking this, it's fucking that. And then every white guy is like, I would never do that and do that. And it's like, what the fuck? You make them pay for a fucking $7,000 trip to Vegas. Yeah, that's something. But when you allow him to call you a name.
Wait, whoa. Where does Vegas come in?
When you're a rookie in the NFL.
You get hazed.
You get hazed. And
what?
That might mean you got to go buy lunch for every guy on the team. But this,
and they might be buying bottles of Dom Perignon from like 1814.
But this guy wants lunch from this place.
In
this
Vegas?
Guy wants it from that place and that place. So you got to drive all around town, spending all your money on this.
Seriously?
Yeah.
It's like a rite of passage from a rookie standpoint.
And then when you're not a rookie anymore,
stupid.
You get to do it to the guys.
Then you get to do it to the rookies that come in.
That really happens?
Like, you buy my shit. Now you get to buy my shit.
Aren't these grown ass men?
Yes.
Yeah. For real.
Well paid grown ass men.
Well, it happened when they were in college too.
They get paid millions. Right.
They went through the shit
in
college. They went through the shit in high school.
College, whatever. But as grown ass men, you have a career. No,
they are men that have grown up playing a sport, and this becomes their living.
Yeah.
They're not mature individuals. All right.
No. Okay. Fair enough.
Except maybe Jerry Rice. He seemed pretty cool.
Why?
I don't know. I came up with a name and I threw it out there.
Except for Jerry Rice. He seemed cool.
I like Jerry Rice.
He's cool. N-word. But I just I said A at the end of it.
Hey.
It's okay. I said A.
Craig,
I said
not
A,
cool,
not
man.
Er.
Hey.
What?
I said A, not Er.
What?
I just don't understand like the whole like I've been listening to it for 2 weeks on ESPN and everybody says that if you say A, it's cool.
What?
Like you're a brotherhood, like Ritchie Incognito has been deemed, like all of his teammates say that he is more black, and he's the whitest guy that you'll ever find. He's big, he's black.
What does that even mean?
He's big and he's
what
white.
What does that even mean?
Just white as fuck.
What does that even mean?
White with blonde hair.
What does that even mean? No. To be black. What does that even mean?
I don't know. That's what I'm asking.
He's got blackitude.
The guy that he was trying to haze or toughen up is black.
Right.
And all of his teammates say, no, Ritchie was he's more of a black guy than that guy.
Because he's grown up in a sport that's dominated by these big black guys, he's probably...
Okay.
But the reason that he used... The reason that he used that word when talking to a black teammate was because his other black teammates, like... I don't want to say like they...
They all use it, right?
No, but they use it sparingly, but they always called Ritchie his Enna. You're my Enna.
I love how you're dancing around this.
And well, I don't really want to say it.
We're all
I don't
white.
Like saying
we
it,
can't
but,
say it. No, it's
but what I'm saying
not
is
okay
that
for white people to say it.
The
it's
reason
not.
That Ritchie got away with calling the black guy an N-er is because his other black teammates called him an N-a.
Okay, well...
I've never heard that argument.
That's the whole locker room culture.
I'm annoyed. So let me rewind my annoyance real quick. So
he's playing for lunch?
Yeah. I mean, so super white boy ends up calling the newbie black guy the N-word because they're hazing him, and now he's in turmoil because of
really
it.
Really what happened was
he did more than that.
A voicemail was leaked of him calling him that.
I did watch that.
And that's where that whole thing came from. But
this is after the rookie.
But it was part of the hazing situation.
Right.
Because
he got tired of being
verbally abused. He was getting hazed.
Verbally abused.
There was one prank they pulled that broke the back.
Yeah, and this guy got expelled or some shit. I watched it with you,
yeah.
I believe.
Here's my point. Let's say that I'm the black guy or the white guy. It doesn't fucking matter what guy I am. If let's say that all four of us are on a football team, I'm the rookie.
Uh-oh.
You've been here for 5 years. You've been here for four. You've been here for two.
She's the
I'm the veteran.
Yeah,
she's the
you're the veteran. So yeah, you're the quarterback.
Hey.
And you all tell me
that's right. Y'all know I run shit.
That I have to take you to Alexander Steakhouse and buy you whatever the fuck you want. I'm a man. I'm getting paid by the NFL. I don't have to do that. I don't. You guys all tell me that I have to do it. I'll just be like, I don't even know you motherfuckers. I ain't buying your shit.
Yeah, but now your life, now you're not part of
the team.
What
are you going to do, kill me?
No, but now you're not part of the team. And this whole thing is I got your back, you got mine, we're all in this together. And if you're not pulling your weight
of financial weight, you're making more money than me. You've been in the league longer than me. I'm the rookie. I'm the one that has a mortgage.
No, you're not being part of the process. You're not being part of
the process.
Yeah.
That's gross. Even more fuck you, you go buy your own steak.
Yeah.
That's what I would say.
Yeah.
Go buy. Why don't you take me out to dinner?
Yes. I'm the new guy.
Like, I mean, if we're all friends,
make friends,
just
yo.
Fucking
make friends.
Just go out to dinner together and I'll
you
pay
guys,
for my tab.
You guys are forgetting.
For
it's
yours and this
it's
and
not
that.
Like these guys are sitting there going, give me my dinner. Yeah. Now get the fuck out of my face. No, they're like, give me my dinner. They're like, we got you, rookie. We got you. And now they're it's just a part of the culture. It's one of those things where, like, we need you to learn how the respect in this locker room works, and therefore, we're going to treat you like shit.
Mean you.
But afterwards, we're all going to be brothers. And next year, it's not because you bought...
So I have to buy you a $1,600 dinner for you to consider me a brother?
Nobody's eating $1,600 dinners.
Well, no, but the alcohol usually tallies up.
These were lunches. And it's going from place to place. He had to run all over town.
Dom Perignon.
Perignon.
I think you guys are missing the point.
Well, it's just okay. we don't understand that whole mentality of like, I'm going to be part of a club.
Yeah.
And we're going to throw a party, and you're going to clean it up, and you can't come to the party.
I would it's never, like a frat boy it's a frat mentality.
It's retarded. And I would never join a frat.
I wouldn't want to put myself through that. But that's what these guys do. And they all the pros say, yeah, we all went through it. And they all not enjoyed it, but
nobody
they all
enjoyed
see
it.
The benefit of it.
It sounds stupid as shit.
No.
But you've never been a part of it, so
no,
you have no idea
but it still all right.
what the benefit
as fuck.
Is. I mean, didn't you ever have, like, a teacher or somebody that you hated, and then a year later, when you left that person and they're no longer with you, you kind of look back and you're like, man, that sucked. But I really learned a lot of shit from that, and I respect that person now.
Did you have a teacher like that?
Oh, yeah. I had several.
How many?
Well, several.
More than two.
Four.
More than two, less than ten.
Four, William.
Mrs. Albertson, seventh grade.
Nice.
English.
Were they all women?
No, I had a dude.
That's another story.
That's a different time.
Well.
Well, this guy had a dude in high school that would write his fucking term papers for him.
What's his name, William Barron?
His name was William Barron.
He wrote a term paper.
It's fine. He wrote multiples for me, too. It's fine.
Term paper. Jack the Ripper.
I just exchanged and other favors.
Sick. Oh, man.
That was online. We were already at our house right now. What are you talking about?
I know.
No, you're just like, I don't know how to add a comma. And I was like,
you
need a comma
off.
Right
I know how
there.
To add commas.
There's got to be a comma right there.
I just would have rather you done it.
Yeah. Sure.
Look at you being all smart on that computer.
What?
That's so cute.
She would like give me, like, one of the first term papers we ever wrote was about bathroom etiquette.
I like that you say we. I really don't
okay,
have anything
I.
to do with it.
The first term paper that I wrote for
the first
her
term paper that she ever proofread.
And
oh, you didn't even proofread.
And then, yeah, I gave it to her, and then she gave it right back to me within like 15 minutes. I was like, there's no way you read through that.
No, I didn't.
She didn't give a shit.
Looks good.
Worst day of my life at school was when the teacher 110%. Tried to talk to me about it, and I had no fucking clue what the fuck he was talking about.
You gotta at least read it.
No, I didn't.
What was your grade?
An A.
Oh.
Of course.
Yeah, I know it.
Bill only got
much A's in the same way that when I wrote his term paper for Jack the Ripper.
If you were ever in school,
are you compensated
I would do
for
all
this
your math.
Work? I know how you're getting compensated on this side of the table.
How much money did you pay me for Jack the Ripper?
I think it was $10.
$10? I think I started off at 40,
yep.
And then I scratched it out.
Yeah.
And then I said 20, and I shook my head, and I scratched it out, and then I said 10, and he was like,
sold.
So I had to write one 15-page term paper in cursive, which was mine.
Oh, my God.
And then I had to rewrite it in his...
It wasn't even typing?
That's how I got used to this big fucking... Like, Joe always writes in capital letters, except they're littler.
Oh, yeah.
I had to write an entire term paper.
So Molly's quietly shouting.
Yep.
Big little letters.
Big little letters.
Jack the Ripper.
I mean, we're talking about note cards. We're talking about the paper, the first, first draft, the second draft. This bitch brought attention, and she was like, "Nice work, Joseph." Hand it down the table and threw my my paper onto my desk. Like, she was disgusted. I got a C. He got an A. I don't know how that worked.
Oh, my God.
I don't know how that worked, but.
That sucks.
She was just so excited that I was actually doing work.
You know how many times?
Because I didn't do a thing.
How many times
class.
In that semester she made you pull your desk up to the chalkboard and just look at the chalkboard?
I have to imagine that that lady still looks back on her teaching career and thinks of me when she thinks of her most hated student of all time.
I wouldn't say hated.
Really?
I gotta imagine.
No.
She hated me so
Joe,
much.
I can't ever imagine
the only reason that she hated
you.
Was the only reason that she hated was
I didn't
you
do
was that
anything
she,
in that
she
class.
Saw potential. Like, any time that she asked you a question and you had to go up to the front of the class to answer a question, you answered it intelligently and better than fucking Guy Donahue or whoever the fuck.
Guy. I mean, you were in a classroom with a guy named Guy?
Yeah. What's up, guy?
That guy.
That's great.
You know that guy.
Oh, you mean that guy? Yeah, I'm talking about that guy.
Oh, shit.
But she saw that, and you just weren't into the literary arts.
Well, it's funny, because I think I would enjoy it if I would have given it half a shot. But I just couldn't care.
You would have had to spend the night before 8 hours writing the paper.
And I couldn't peel myself away from watching television the night before.
Right. So, like,
or doing your art project.
Right.
Yeah, that was due at the same time.
Yeah.
Your midterm for Miss Bradford.
I would sit there and say, I got all this homework, but it's not due for 2 weeks. Perfect.
Perfect.
I'm going to watch this half-hour comedy hour marathon on MTV.
The next 2 weeks.
For 2 weeks.
Well,
this is going to end
recorded on
beautifully.
Mario Joyner was hosting, so I...
I had to watch it.
Mario, who?
He's the future of comedy in America.
Oh, my.
Yeah, good times. Thanks for bringing that up.
All right.
But you look back at it now and you're like, oh, I could have totally aced all
that. I could have graduated high school.
God.
Oh, you didn't. I think Bill likes bringing up doing shit for people.
Oh, is that it?
Oh, he never fails to remind me that he wrote my papers for college.
He's got a, yeah.
Fails to remind you. How many times does that come up in conversation?
Many.
We'll be like.
More than it should.
Why don't you drive the speed limit, honey? Well, why don't you write your own fucking term papers, bitch?
Yes, yes. That's exactly what happens. However,
yeah, you think
if,
so?
If you ever went back to school, don't tell me you wouldn't have me do your math homework.
Well, I would never take a math class if I went back to school.
Well.
Whatever.
Whatever.
Well, I
fuck
wouldn't.
Off.
Nice.
Fuck math.
I'm just saying. If you ever did, and you had a math class.
Who needs math?
I would take your math
and
class.
Science.
No, because I would have to be there at the end when I take the test.
Not if you did it online. Which is what I did.
True. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, fine. Fine.
Ha!
I would hire
ever
you.
Ever heard of a calculator?
No. No. I hate calculators.
God, do you know how easy it would be to go to school now with the internet?
Pretty easy. Actually, I mean, it's math classes are kind of hard because you have to teach yourself completely how to do all of it.
Yeah, but
unless you're good at math, it's hard as fuck.
If you forget a formula or something, you just type it in Google and then bam, there it is.
Yeah.
What?
Done.
How do you do that little check mark line thing on
the
keyboard?
You gotta
write the. You write the.
Yeah, there's an option for it.
You write the verbal word.
Well, you're not gonna see it. You just gotta. It's a keystroke option something.
Well, that's check mark line, the square root, right? The square root sign?
Is that the square root sign?
Yeah.
With the... There we go. Yeah.
What's that one thing? It's got a dot and a line of a dot.
See, English literature classes, you can't do that.
What about that thing that looks like a cross? Yeah.
You can't Google search your shit, and it can't happen. Because then you plagiarize, and then you get fucking kicked
out of
school.
But what you can do is Google search someone else explaining it, read it, reinterpret it.
YouTube it.
And done.
What I married him for.
That's what I would do.
Sweet.
Anyway.
Anyhow.
Do you guys got any new apps on your phone that are worth the shit?
I do, actually.
I downloaded a new app.
Nobody's probably going to care. Oh, you don't really want to hear the answer? You just
were asking
me.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just giving you a little bit of a little
bit. I downloaded an app called Runtastic.
What's that?
It's a new workout app that I have.
Runtastic.
Kind of
so what do you do
it.
With it?
I see you got Snapchat.
I did. I haven't used it yet.
What's that do?
Snapchat?
Yeah.
Snapchat.
I don't get it.
You, I'm going to take a picture of me. Yeah. Uh-huh.
And then I'm going to send it to you. Okay. And you, are you ready?
And we're telling a story?
Are you ready?
Are we telling
a
story?
Are you ready for this?
Okay.
Hold on. Yep. Hold on. I'm going to take a picture of me. And then I'm going to send it to you.
He's being Kevin Hart.
And then you only get 3 seconds to look at it.
Oh, I've heard of that.
And it's deleted forever.
Yeah.
Forever.
Can't you set a time limit on it? Oh, but then someone does the screenshot and they save it forever.
But you have 10 seconds to do that screenshot.
That was Incognito's problem. You should have been Snapchatting. Have that disappear forever. Yeah. Come back and bite him later.
Been like, fuck you, burning a cross in his left hand.
I'm going to blank your mom's blank and blank this and blank that, you stupid blank.
No, it's not a voice. It's just a picture. Snapchat. It's just a picture. It's not what
so
you're
it's
saying.
Pictures of him doing that to his mom.
Wearing a fucking
KKK
hat.
A KKK hat.
Flipping him off and Snapchat him. Mm. And then he'd be gone forever. Nobody would have ever seen him.
No history at all.
Nobody.
Nope.
Instead, he was a dumbass. He left it on a voicemail.
Well, it's on the internet somewhere.
Yes.
It's on the cloud somewhere.
Yeah.
Oh. Someone has it.
Oh, ESPN has it. ESPN.
Those guys hack into somebody's shit, I bet. I bet they've got hackers. Get into that guy's cell phone and get me that email.
That's why I don't believe in Snapchat.
Yeah.
It's fucking out there somewhere. Somebody's keeping that shit.
I know.
It's on your fucking phone. Yep. Somebody's keeping it.
I got this new app. I don't know if you've heard about it. It's called a calculator.
Oh.
The one that comes with...
It's in your settings, Craig.
Is that for my math class that I'm not going to take?
Yeah. That's for those math problem barons.
I am good at math.
I do very simple math on that calculator.
You know, if you turn it over, it becomes a scientific calculator.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I did know that.
Like a Texas Instrument?
In landscape view.
Wow.
Put that, and it goes like this.
Look at all them goddamn buttons.
Is there a square
root
button?
Look at all them buttons.
Yeah, there is.
There's your little check mark button.
Where is it?
Square root? There's a pie? There's a fucking...
What the fuck did you need three of them for?
This is ridiculous.
3 times, x times y.
Algebraic equations.
Sine, cosine, tangent. Maybe. S, x, exclamation point.
Maybe we should have a spinoff podcast.
This just in, I got 24 miles to the gallon, my last fill up.
Hi.
I would be completely useless. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening to the William Barron Show. Brought to you by Wix.com, W-I-X.com.
That's the
Wix.
End of the cast?
Joe, tell me where we're at with Wix.com.
Wix.com, you need a website for your business or for your personal use. You go to Wix.com. They'll get you all set up. Professional, grade looking, extra, extra special support.
Craig, you mentioned that you saw a Wix ad on television, or was it Facebook?
It was Facebook.
It was Facebook?
Yeah.
They got this new commercial coming out.
Yeah, they did.
I got to admit that I feel like we have something to do with it.
It sounds like us.
Does it?
Like, it really does. Watch the TV commercials. It's on ESPN all the time.
Did they use my voice?
It might as well.
I might have to check it out.
It might
copyright
as well.
What's going on here.
They legitimately say W-I-X.
W-I-X.com.
Wix. W-I-X.com.
Yeah.
Because people keep putting in W-I-C-K-S.
Right. And they're like, candles? Yeah. What the fuck?
I can't build a website with this.
Yeah, make sure, ladies and gentlemen, when you go to the website, it's W-I-X. As in...
Extreme.
As in... as in Dwayne...
Triple X.
The Rock.
The Rock.
Johnson.
Dwayne Johnson, the X, .com. Check them out. They do good shit. We will see you guys next week. Danielle, thank you for coming.
Thank you. That was a quick-ass podcast.
Greg Ketchum.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for being here. Joseph.
Always a pleasure.
Amazing.
Bless you all.
Bless you all. Hey, make sure to send us your topics. We'll talk about them next week. This is the William Barron Show, brought to you by Wix.com. You're the top of the town, but you're